Hi folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to. Today we're going to be connecting to MinIO using Java. And in this video, I'm actually using OpenJDK 19 and Maven 4 to manage my Java environment. And we're going to be connecting out to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox for anybody who wants to work with the MinIO platform. And I'm going to be running all of this out of VS Code. Really, just a couple of things I'm going to be looking at in this video. I'm going to be showing you how to set up some Maven dependencies for your project if you're doing your project out of Maven. If you're doing your project with another tool, we may have some examples for you. We do have a full set of examples for Gradle out on our MinIO GitHub repository. That's the MinIO Java GitHub repository. And once we've got our Maven dependencies all handled, I'm going to show you how to work with the MinIO client builder, which is how you actually connect to MinIO. Let's take a look at the code. So here we have a very simple public class app, and this public class app is going to do one thing. It's going to run a demo function for me. In order to run this, I needed to import the MinIO client as well as the MinIO exception, and I need to be working with a bucket because I'm going to do a count of how many buckets are actually out on our play.min.io platform at this moment. Of course, to use all these excellent classes that we built for you, you have to have access to the MinIO jars and the MinIO libraries. And the way you want to do that is here in your POM file, which is what you use to set up your Maven repositories and all that other fun stuff. We're going to be using a dependency for MinIO. And this is the dependency that you need right here. It is group ID io.minio, artifact ID MinIO, and then the version number for this is 8.4.5. And of course you'd need to set up a similar dependency if I was using Gradle or something along those lines. But this dependency then allows us to use all of this MinIO goodness right in our code. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to walk you through what I'm doing with the main method. It's very simple. I am calling this demo call to get a MinIO client, and then I'm doing a very simple list buckets and getting a size of how many buckets I have out there. If there's an exception, we'll get a connection failed. If there's a MinIO exception, like an access denied exception, something along those lines, or maybe your authentication doesn't work, you're going to see this connection failed with a message. And then last but not least, if there's any other kind of exception, I'm just going to do a print stack trace. Pretty common stuff. But the key piece of work is being done here by the demo function. So let's go ahead and I'll roll this back up. We'll take a look at the demo function. And all the demo function is doing is it's actually creating a MinIO client and returning it so that I can work with it. So really, let's go ahead and focus in on this MinIO client builder that we're going to be using. So the MinIO client class has this static builder method, which we use to set all of the variables that we need to actually connect to MinIO. And what I've got here are the basics. I need an endpoint, and my endpoint here is play.min.io. I'm using HTTPS, so that tells me that we're actually going to be using a secure connection. Our credentials here, our access key and our secret key, these are actually common to play.min.io. Anybody can use those to connect out to play.min.io. And then I'm calling the build function to actually create this MinIO client object, which I then hand back and do whatever other work I need to do. There are a few different ways to set an endpoint. You can give it that full URL. You can also give it a URL, a port number. You can give it a number of different things here. You can do an access key and a secret key for the credentials, or you can use a credentials provider. Another thing that you can do is you can use this HTTP client. So our MinIO client is actually going to be using underneath the hood an OK HTTP client, and that allows us to do some special work with that client should we need to. It's fairly uncommon that you would need to do that. And last but not least, you can always set a region. So if your server is on one region or another, you can actually tell it which region you're going to be working with. So that allows you to make whatever settings you need to do on your MinIO client, and then you can actually just build it and run it. So let's go ahead and we'll save this. I've been running around making changes to this, so we'll go ahead and save it. So we're going to go ahead and build this with Maven clean package. And I've set this up to actually build an executable jar file for me. And there it is. It's my target demo 1.0 jar. So I'm going to do a java-jar. And I'm just going to hand it target demo. And we're going to go ahead and run this. And my results after running it is that I've got connection success. And I've got a total of 9 buckets up on play.min.io. Clearly, what probably happened recently is somebody got on there and just deleted everything. It happens sometimes on play.min.io. if you run similar code to this, you're probably going to get a different number of total buckets just because the number of buckets changes all the time because anybody can work with play.min.io. Let me show you what happens if there's a MinIO exception. I'm going to go ahead and take the F off of the end of my access key. We'll save that. We're going to build and run this again. There's my build, and we'll go ahead and run this one more time. So as you can see, now when I run it, I've got a connection failed because I had that MinIO exception pop up, says the access key ID you provided does not exist in our records. Of course, because I am not using the right access key. So that's our demo. I've shown you how to set up a MinIO client object here using Java, how to connect to an endpoint using some credentials, build that out, and go. Keep in mind, you can also set up a region, and if you need to manipulate the HTTP client running underneath the MinIO client, you can always set a custom one. If you'd like to reach out to us, you can use any of the methods that you see here on the screen. And you can also connect with us interactively on Slack at minio.slack.com, or you can just leave us a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.